I built this solar station to convert solar radiation into heat in this house in winter and heat in the water of this pool in summer, and for experimental testing of this new type of solar heaters. You can see there are similarities with these mirror systems of solar power plants, the total value of which in all countries has already exceeded $40 billion. Their parabolic mirrors focus solar radiation into this expensive receiver, which costs 10 times more than the cheap receivers of my solar heaters. I remind you that my previous video described these pipes, and now I will show you the complete assembly of my receivers and their technical condition after several years of operation. After that, I will compare my receivers with this more expensive alternative, which must work with concentrated solar radiation in high temperatures, and therefore it is much more expensive than the widely known evacuated tubes. First of all, I have to fix these metal sheets on these structures, which consist of various metal and wooden parts, which we can now examine. These structures were installed using 6 screws. Those sheets were already equipped with a layer of thermal insulation and 2 wooden slats, which are needed for fastening with these bolts and these self-tapping screws. These 2 cheap wires make the row of receivers resistant to longitudinal loads, and I used 2 pairs of wires per long row. My previous video showed how I installed these pipes for circulation of a heat transfer fluid. You may notice these large gaps between adjacent pipes, but this is not a problem, because these mirrors direct the solar radiation in such a way. In addition, almost all of the energy of these photons that fly past the pipes will end up in the pipes through air and radiation. The pipes of one of the ends must be connected in this way, as described in the previous video. This is the second end of the pipes. Then the receiver thermal insulation was put in order. Sometimes I installed aluminum foil under the pipes, but maybe it was unnecessary. This is a high temperature paint because the mirrors can heat the unfilled pipes to temperatures about 200 degrees Celsius. These sections complete the assembly of the receiver, and I plan to make an additional video with a more detailed description of this polyethylene film, its capabilities and its alternatives. These are those metal sheets after 6 years of use in the open air, and this is cheap galvanized steel with a thickness of 300 microns. Now on the right there is the same receiver but 6 years ago, and we understand that the lifespan of the receiver will be more than 10 or 20 years, but here we see corrosion. The technical condition of the pipes was shown in the previous video. This is the percentage of efficiency of my receiver, and we see that the percentage decreases due to the increase in the temperature difference between the heat transfer fluid and the surrounding air. If it is not black paint, but a selective coating, the efficiency will improve approximately like this. The efficiency of these evacuated tubes will be like this at the flow of concentrated solar radiation. We see that an evacuated tube will be radically better at these high temperatures, but my receiver is more suitable for these low temperatures, which are needed for heating pool water and home heating. In addition, this large height of the receiver is an advantage if we use cheap mirrors of poor accuracy or for other reasons which will be described in the next video. I also remind you that my future videos will show the making and installation of other parts of my solar heaters, this heat storage and possibly other parts of my heating system.